my face, touching me with a shoulder. I decided, screw it, and I took a long back. I landed in, my fist landed in the spot right between his eye and the bridge of his nose. I think he was in a state of shock because he spat in my face and went to the bathroom. I won the first physical fight I was ever in. Felt like I should have been on the top of the world, right? I stood up to a bully and won. Wasn't that a big accomplishment or something? But instead from that moment on, I became more aggressive when people asked me personal questions and tried to get me to be open. I was cold, distant, and kind of a major asshole. I found myself in the monotony of life. School, work, ride horses, sleep, repeat. The schedule forced me out of my house and made me actually communicate with other people. I began to realize the people I could really trust, and the few that I put forth my energy, what little I had of it, and into. Dear friend, thank you once again. Because you messed me up and you made me learn from it, teaching me how I truly don't care about the haters, if you will, and I thought through the actions that I had made. I fixed them the best of my ability, and I'm not really an open person, but this is something bigger than myself. Sure, I wanted my senior year to go out with a bang, but this is because I want at least one single person to get something out of my experiences. I wish I had the time to roll off the list of all the amazing people who made an impact on me, but I just don't have the time. So this is it. The end of the story so far. Senior year has been a wild ride, but I can honestly say I'm ready for what's ahead. Stay frosty, friend, high school. Ryan Farrar. Originally on deck, waiting for her return, completely unaware. Eventually, the insiders made We were all prepared to save this old lady at any cost. Another 10 minutes go by before we even start the service. I talked to the guard who initially started the save, and he said the old lady was shouting in pain and clutching her chest, even though it was a leg cramp that went away a minute later. None of us could believe what had happened. It went from life to death to nothing at the snap of a finger. As a cherry on top, the old lady stayed long after closing, complaining to the managers about the obnoxious kids and how cold the water is. I don't think she realized the immense panic she caused and how close we were to summoning emergency services. Despite the frequent chaos, I plan on returning this summer and will most likely come out with a new and very long list of strange public school occurrences again. Thank you.
Frank was
started tripping and people are strolling about in the afternoon sun. It would be beautiful if there weren't so many ominous, unknown variables. Frank snatches the pizza up and slams the door so hard it rattles the picture of Carol had put up on the wall. Frank can't be bothered with it and went right to locking up the door. Have you really forgotten to do this morning? His hands shook as he slipped. I'm like about to sneeze. His hands shook as he slipped. Deadbolts closed and chains and slots. He needed to calm down. He draws shut the curtains to make sure all the lights in the house are turned off before he sits down to his dinner. He can feel a buzzing in the back of his head, but he ignores it as he takes out the pizza. He ignores it until the buzzing morphs into wailing, and then screaming, and then it's a thousand voices, a chorus of shrill yapping, the sound of the yawning chasms of oblivion. Why couldn't he calm down? Why didn't anyone leave him alone? His fingers footed through his hair, and they pulled, and they pulled, and it was so hard not to scream himself. Frank?